Let me share the screen. Now, this is the paper 301. Okay. Now, it's the generic 4 external paper, which is 301, that is strategic management. Now, here you will have evaluation of 50 marks external and 50 marks internal for this course, this paper. if we have the outline, brief outline of the syllabus for this subject, then it is understanding what is the meaning of strategy, basically. What actually comprises of strategy. The next is analyzing company's internal environment. The third is generic competitive strategies. Fourth is strategy implementation. Whether the PPT is visible? Hello?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. And then last part is the blue ocean strategy. This is the new part which has been included. That is the blue ocean strategy. Now, when I say understanding the strategy, okay. It means the concept of strategy. Exactly what are the types or levels of strategy? Now here, when we say it's a level of strategies, it depends upon the business domain into which the business is working out. That is, whether it's a corporate entity, whether it is a very small organization, whether it is an agriculture-based organization. So here on the basis of the scope of the business, okay, the level of strategies are defined at the corporate level, the business level, and the functional levels. So here the basics, like in the first chapter, would include the meaning of strategic management exactly. What is the distinction between the strategy, the tactics, the management process, strategic management process, the role of stakeholder in strategic management. What is the meaning of the concept of vision and mission, and how this it revolves around the strategic management process. What is the difference between both the terms, the vision and the mission? What are the characteristics of a good mission statements? Why it is important? Goals and objectives, and linking it to the mission and the vision of the organization. Here it also comprises the critical success factors, the key performance indicators, the key area results, the components of a strategic plan, analyzing the external environment. Because whenever an organization functions, it functions in the environment of competition. It cannot be aloof from the society as such. So here there are many environmental factors which are working on this organization. So environmental appraisal, the scenario of planning, the metrics of threat and opportunity profile. Whenever an organization thinks from the perspective of environment, okay, so here it takes into account the opportunities as well as it has to encounter the threats moving ahead in the environmental scenario. Similarly, the industry analysis with reference to Porter's 5 forces model of competition and the entry strategies and the exit strategies as well as the barriers to both of this. So all this is included in this first chapter of understanding the strategy. The next part comprises analyzing the company's internal environment. Now, when I say it's internal environment, it means it is the self-evaluation of an organization. The organization self-evaluates. Whether you can see this part of the syllabus part, which I am discussing. Hello. Analyzing what are the company's resources, its competitive position. So the meaning, the types of sources of competitive advantage, the VRIO framework, the core competencies, characteristics of core competencies, and what are the benchmarking methods like comparative analysis, value chain analysis using Porter's model, organizational capability profile. So how advantageous is the strategic point of view or the strategic portfolio of an organization? How the resources are distributed, whether they are concentrated, they are accumulated, they are conserving or recovering. That is, we would be going for the portfolio analysis of the business. And there are two methods. They are the BCG matrix and the GE9 cell model. These are the two methodologies for this portfolio analysis. So this is about the internal environment. The next is the generic competitive strategies, like meaning of what do you understand by competitive strategies? Some of the companies opt for low cost, while some of them, they go for the differentiation strategy. That is, put something unique into a service offering or a product offering, quote the prices and offer it to the customers. So something different from the competitors. Well, against this, maybe the company is there where for them low cost strategy is affordable. So which strategy has to be used when? That is what we are going to study in this part. Grand strategies like stability, growth. These are all the diversification strategies or vertical integration strategies, the mergers, the acquisition, takeover, alliance with the other companies. In some cases, retrenchment, like turnaround, divestment, liquidation, and outsourcing strategies. This comprises in the third chapter of understanding the generic competitive strategies. The fourth one is strategy implementation. Now here, what are the barriers when a company thinks of implementing the strategy? Mintzberg's 5 P's. Nicholson's 7S framework. Maybe you might have studied this in the fundamentals of management. The organization structures for strategy implementation, like functional, divisional, strategic business unit, matrix, network structures. Again, you have seen this in the management fundamentals. Changing structures and processes, how it affects the organization, the re-engineering, and strategy implementation. What is the principles of re-engineering, the corporate culture, building learning organizations, promoting participation, that is management by objectives, operations control, strategic control, and the concept of balanced scorecard for strategy evaluation. That is a part of the strategy implementation, which is our fourth chapter. The last part is the blue ocean strategy, where basically it defines the scope of red ocean strategy and blue ocean strategy, the difference between the principles of both the strategies, the action four action framework, business models, what is its meaning, what are the components of business models, new business models for internet economy, e-commerce business strategies, okay, which is nowadays in a boom. Even how the internet strategies are useful for the traditional business, the virtual value chain, sustainability, startups growth and the reason for decline, the threats to sustainability, all this is in the fifth chapter, that is the Blue Ocean Strategy. So this is a brief outline or the framework of this strategic management course. Now here in this, we would be discussing the case studies also with reference to that particular points. Now, why one should think of opting or studying this strategic management? What is a strategy? Hello?
स्ट्रैटेजी मीन्स मैम अगर कुछ भी नया स्टार्ट करना है तो उसके लिए स्ट्रैटेजी लगता है, दैट इज कि क्या करना है, कब कौन सी सिचुएशन पे क्या चेंजेस करने, दैट इज अ स्ट्रैटेजी.
ओके,
फॉर एग्जांपल प्रिपरेशन ऑफ एग्जांपल, उसके लिए स्ट्रैटेजिकली फर्स्ट यूनिट कितने टाइम में खत्म करना है, दैट इज द स्ट्रैटेजी.
Okay, so when we think from the business perspective, okay, as I said, business alone cannot perform, okay, or business alone is not there. It comes with other entities, isn't it? We have different stakeholders for the business, like we have the employees whose care should be taken by the organization. There is the government who has its own rules and regulations. There is a society, okay. That's why we have the corporate social responsibility framework. Then we have the competitors. Today, if we see any of the business, it does not function in isolation. They have to perform, they have to work in the era of competition, isn't it? Today, it's an era of cutthroat competition. And one has to survive in this era of cutthroat competition. There are many uncertainties. You will never know what things will happen tomorrow. Like if you consider the government strategy, okay, government policies, nobody can predict what would be the policies with reference to any angle or maybe area. Like environmental concerns, okay, have introduced the Tetra Packs. That was one of the important thing with the help of technology in transformation. Or maybe from the financial perspectives. So here, government keeps a check on the businesses, the people. So, the services or the products are for the people, designed by the people, for the people. So one has to take into consideration the concern of society or the people in totality. So the well-being of people becomes the priority of the organization. Now, whenever after this MBA course, you will be entering as managers, entry-level managers, isn't it? So maybe you would be operating at the functional level. And then slowly and steadily, you will move ahead with your promotions to the towards the journey. Your journey begins towards the corporate level. Now here, when I say corporate, it means an umbrella, you can say, which incorporates many businesses. You can take an example of a Reliance. Reliance operates in which of the businesses? Many businesses. Okay, so we say it's a multidimensional. It's not confined to a single business. When an organization operates in more than one businesses, okay, we say it works on the corporate level. When the decisions are taken in totality, which will affect all these organizations, we say it's a corporate decision. The business environment is ever changing and there are a lot of opportunities to explore for these businesses. But with these opportunities are the associated risks in it. And decision making is one of the very important aspect of any business. Now, due to competition or due to technology, there are many inventions going on as well as innovations taking place. If we see the packaging part, I gave an example of Tetra packing. It is a outcome of an innovations. Many of the companies invest lot of their resources in their R&D, research and development of an organization. What is the reason for this? Because they want to come up with the innovative ideas, many innovative applications, which will attract the customers, which will satisfy the customers. When the company thinks of providing any product or service to the customer, they should be satisfied. Now, the era, today it's an era of globalization and liberalization. So, the organizations compete on the global platform. An organization always has to be on toes to fight with the competitors. The decentralization is one of the important aspects when we take into consideration this globalization part. As we know that each and every nation has their own requirements, one cannot think of offering a single product or service to all of the clientels throughout the globe. When you enter into one nation, their requirements are different, and that's why you need to mold the product or the service and cater to the needs of that segment. As you enter the other nation, again, you need to analyze the environment of that nation and try to mold the product or the service and offer the desired or the required product or a service. There are very few companies who have been successful, okay, as far as the global marketing management is considered, to penetrate into the markets with the standardized product offering or the service offering. Here you can take an example of the automobile sector, where as far as the basic product or the service product is considered, very less changes have been made. Whatever is offered, it's offered in a standardized form uniquely throughout the globe. Otherwise, in case of other products, modifications have to be done. Now, because of this competition, the companies think of the opportunities and the threats analysis. The changing business environment necessitates the managers to think about the future, to move ahead and to be on their toes. Now, the strategic management, it involves theories. It provides the basic framework of various strategical theories, its pros and cons. In what situation, which type of strategy will work? Okay, a broad framework is put up here. Strategic management helps to look forward to the managers. It is a continuous process. It sets a direction. It gives a clear understanding of where the company wants to head in future, based on the clear understanding of the vision and the mission statement. Now here, strategic planning, which is a subset of this strategic management process, plays a very vital role in this. Here, the managers take into consideration the past history of the organization, or we can say the trends the current situation of the organization and plan for the future based upon this past and the present. It includes the planning of strategic decisions, the activities, the resource allocation of the funds needed to achieve particular goals or the aims or objectives set by the organization. It helps in gaining the competitive edge and improve the market share. Ultimately, what is the basic aim of any business or corporate entity? Why anybody starts the business? Yes. What is the purpose of business?
Profit making.
Profit making. And how you are going to make the profit? You reach more customers. More the number of customers, more they are satisfied, more is the word of mouth publicity, and ultimately it is reflected in profits. So this strategic management helps in assessing the organization's current strategic direction. So where does the organization stand in the competitive environment? So this strategic management will help a manager to assess in identifying and analyzing internal and external strengths and weaknesses. So here when we take this environment into consideration, it becomes easy to analyze the core strengths of an organization and also the weaknesses. Now here each and every company will try to have a 360 degrees developmental approach, but sometimes it is not possible. Maybe your particular organization is financially very good, the other one is technologically very sound, and so on. And that's why this necessitates the manager to have an overview of organizational profile. Now, when the company thinks of coming up with the objectives, making the plans to achieve those objectives becomes necessary. How to achieve the particular objective is formulation. And the next step is, once you have formulated, evaluating it or executing it is the other part. While execution of the actual plan, one comes to know what are the loopholes in it. Planning is fine. Okay, everybody is going to have the plans, but achieving it will give a clear-cut idea of the roadblocks, that there are certain problems. Now, overcoming the problems again and moving ahead, that is what is required here. Evaluating to what degree action plans have been successful, making necessary or certain changes at the desired level, and moving ahead. Now, this becomes like a method of trial and error, though we have predefined theories. But still, as business is non-predictable, when the managers move ahead with the action plan, they understand what exactly is it. Because one move from our side, from the organization side, will stimulate the business environment. The other businesses will also react to it. So here, this strategic management will help the managers to understand the basics of the strategies, how to go about as far as the environmental factors are considered, how they will affect the organization. Now, if you take an example of the company, okay, Kellogg's. Kellogg's is into the basic cereals industry, isn't it? when it entered into India, the strategies failed because they thought of implementing the same strategies which were implemented in UK. The UK market is much more different than the Indian market. Now, for penetrating into the market or to be successful, they had to change their objectives. They had to change their in totality, the strategy as far as the product positioning itself is considered in India. Now, here they had to stress on the balanced diet. Okay, looking into the Indian culture of having the breakfast, okay, they stressed on healthy and balanced diet. And slowly and steadily, they started penetrating into the market by convincing the customers to think about the health issue and have a balanced diet approach. They went for branding strategies. Now, branding strategies, how do you build a brand? You have studied this, no, in first year. When you think of having a product positioning, okay, there is certain set of influence of perception of the consumers with that particular product. The product choices are based upon the perceptions, which influence the consumer confidence. Slowly, when the customer is satisfied, it starts building up the chain. Okay. And when the customer is satisfied, when the product is of a premium quality or a high quality, value for money. And then we say it's a building of a brand or the brand image. When Jio entered the market, what was the scene? Now today, many of them are using the Jio services, isn't it? When it entered into the market, what was the scenario? It had to face a cutthroat competition from Airtel, as well as the other competitors. It had to go for the market skimming strategy. That is, decrease the price and enter into the market. And that's why today we see it has been successful. As far as the services are considered, it had to prove itself. So when the company enters into the competitive market, certain benchmarks are set by the pioneers. A pioneer is, who is a pioneer? A company which enters into the market first and foremost. The company enters into the market, it depends upon the customers or the consumers, whether they accept it or not. If they accept it, if they are satisfied, then well and good. Otherwise, if it is not accepted, this pioneer will have to change the strategies, okay, to move ahead and get the recognition. Once the pioneer sets the stage for the followers, it becomes much more easy to follow and move ahead in the market. So, whenever there is a pioneer, the struggle is with these pioneers because the market is new, the product is new in the market. And for the followers, it just copies the idea and enters into the market. But many a times, there is a possibility that this follower may achieve the market leader position as compared to the pioneer also. So So the responsibility on the pioneer is much more. But they also have the advantage of getting the market share as well as setting the benchmark in the market. Similarly, if you see the jewelry, gems and jewelry business, okay, the businesses which are on the, in India, if you take into consideration on the national level, the brands which operate on the national levels, it becomes difficult for this to penetrate into the local market, because the local market being localized, okay, adapt the culture of that particular area. The people are more attached to that local marketer as compared to this national player, okay? So it becomes difficult. Now here, if we take an example of a brand like Tanishq, it has or it is still fighting for the market share in this gold jewelry's business as compared with these localites in any of the areas. Because the trust and faith gained by the local players in this business is more as compared to these national players. So here, in terms of customer relationship management, these national players have to prove themselves. They have to go an extra mile to prove themselves as compared to these local marketers. They have to build up certain strategies wherein they can attract the customers. Now here, when you will enter into the managerial levels, okay, in any of the businesses, the first and foremost thing you should understand about the strengths of the organization, about the competitors, who are the competitors of your organization, what strategies they are implementing, what strategy you can think of to uplift the organization's goodwill or the portfolio in totality. Now, when we will study in detail the strategies, okay, then you will understand what are the different aspects of it. It gives you the overview or the picture of it. Now, this is the reason why you should go for this topic, that is the strategic management. Now, when we say it's a strategy we are using. The first chapter is about understanding the strategy. That is the concept of strategy. What do you mean by strategy? The levels of strategy, which includes the corporate, business and functional level. The characteristics, the distinction between tactics and strategy, the strategic management process, the strategic intent, concept of vision and mission. So this is included in the first chapter. Now, anybody of you who plays the chess game, you have seen the chess, isn't it? In that game, there are players, two players, no? What they are doing? They are making moves, isn't it? One makes a move and then the other makes a move. So what are they doing? They are thinking about the future and then making a move. Similarly here, let's see what is a strategy. A strategy is a business approach to a set of competitive moves that are designed to generate a successful outcome. Now, successful outcome is a generalized term. It may be in terms of profits, these outcomes, okay, may reflect in terms of profits. They may reflect in terms of gaining the market share. A company, a particular company may have a plan of increasing the market share. Okay, the other company may have the vision that within next 2-3 years, we may have the more profits. One of the company may have the vision that we want to become a number one leader in that particular market. So here, it depends upon the company where it wants to head in future. So we say, this is a future-oriented task. So a strategy is a business approach. Business approach in the competitive environment. Okay, there is nothing as personalized approach here. From the business perspective, when the companies take a decision to move ahead, to set up competitive moves, that is in the competitive environment. Okay, you take some decision which is going to affect the competitors in one way or the other, that is the meaning of this competitive moves that are designed to generate a successful outcome. Now, this word strategy, it has been derived from the Greek word that is strategia, ya phir strategy goes. This was usually used in armed forces, the military forces. Now, usually there, during the war time, okay, this term was used that against the enemies, what strategy is this military forces is planning? And hence the word has been derived in this competitive environment today. Since we have the industries which has been recognized as competitors. So here, as they used to have the strategies to defeat the competitive military forces. Similarly, here also, the term implies that to defeat the competitors, you come up with the moves, you make the moves, or you make the strategies. That is a war-winning diplomacy. A strategy of a corporation is a comprehensive master plan how corporation will achieve its mission and objectives. See, any organization, it has its own mission statement. It has its vision. Why the company is in the market? Okay. It specifies through its vision and mission statement why a particular organization is in the market, why it is there, into which business. Now here this vision and mission statement, tomorrow we will discuss in detail. But whenever you take the name of a brand, you understand into which businesses the company is operating, isn't it? So here we say it is a comprehensive master plan. It is not a brief, it's very elaborate. Comprehensive plan. It reflects the mission of the organization, the objectives of the organization. Now, it's not that a strategy can be developed only at the corporate level. A strategy can be developed at all the levels of an organization. If you take any level, maybe at the very small, you know, departmental level also in a, they can develop the strategies. At a business level, one can think of developing the strategies. At the corporate level, one can think of having the strategies. So a strategy has a much broader scope. We can say a pool of strategy can become a subset of the overall strategic management process. So here, at the individual level, see how it is linked with the structure of an organization. We have a different departments. Like we have HR department, we have marketing department, we have production department, we have finance department, and so on. R&D department. Each and everybody is responsible for their own performance. They have been assigned the responsibility as well as they are given the free leverage to take the decision. So here, the strategy revolves around the decision-making process. And in the well-being or the on the positive note or for the betterment of the organization, any decision which is being taken by the manager is welcomed. So here, in the anticipation of the well-being of the organization, the managers are expected to take the decision at their own level. It may be a departmental level, it may be at the strategic business unit level. That's why we say a strategy can be developed at all levels of the organization. Now, what is a SBU? What is a strategic business unit? Any idea? What is an SBU? Now, most of the companies, they operate in different businesses. They are not into a single business. They often define the businesses, maybe in terms of the services or in terms of the product. They are into pharmaceutical business, they are into auto business, they are into FMCG category. They are into electronic goods category. Okay. So here, when the company identifies itself in a particular area, in a particular scope, it becomes then profit-making entity. It has its own customer groups associated. The customer needs differ. And the technology also. Now here, for the company to be a strategic business unit, okay, it has to be a single business or a collection of related businesses that can be planned separately from the rest of the company. So here, one can think of having a business which are interlinked or interconnected. That is the raw material, maybe a finished good of one industry or company can be used as a raw material for the other company. Like you may have the extracting the iron ore factories, okay? And this iron ore is further used as a raw material in some other business, or extracting the steel, manufacturing the steel, which is used by the same company, okay, as a raw material for preparation of something else, maybe auto spare parts or something. It should have its own set of competitors. That is the second characteristics. It should have its own competitors. Next thing, it has a manager. It should have a manager who is taking care of that independent unit, who is responsible for strategic planning and profit performance of that individual entity. He controls the factors affecting the profit. Then we say it is a strategic business unit. So here it is expected that a strategic business unit should have its own vision and the mission statement. It should have independent, its own set of competitors and a manager who is responsible for its performance. These three are the aspects for the SBU, that is the strategic business unit. Now, any doubts up till here? I have not entered much into the theoretical aspect except making you understand the meaning of the strategy. So here, in the next session, we will start with the levels of business strategies. So this mission statements, okay, or the allocation of resources, the type of decisions like allocation of resources, what would be the mission statement of an organization? All this is a part of the corporate business strategy at the corporate level. When you have different SBUs, then deciding upon the resource allocation, how much resources are to be allocated to which business, is a part of corporate business strategy. The performance of individual unit, any decision with reference to performance of an individual entity or individual strategy, it is with reference to that single entity. So we say it's a business level decision making or a business level strategy. Similarly, in this business level strategies, you have independent departments who are operating at their own level. And if they take certain decisions, we say it's operational decision making or at the operational level. So like this, we have the bifurcations, which I will discuss in detail tomorrow. Now, any doubts up till here? This was just an overview of strategic management and how it is helpful for you in decision making. Now, the next session is AFM. So finance students, please join for the session. For this week, we will have three sessions. The other specialization students should join for the common sessions. As far as your SIPs are considered, see to it that you complete it at as early as possible. Okay. So today I will stop here. From tomorrow onwards, we will start with the detailing of the first chapter. Okay. Thank you.
Thank you, ma'am.
Okay.
Thank you, ma'am.
Okay.